Good afternoon, everyone. I, Gaurang Tiwari, on behalf of SAEJUT India, warmly welcome Mr. Parvesh Alam, sir, senior technical recruiter with Collabra and one of our honorable and bright alumni of our university. It is my utmost pleasure to have you here, sir. Today, Parvesh sir will brief us about working of staffs and recruitment firms. Now, I would like to hand over the meeting to Parvesh sir. Sir, to you.
All right. Thank you, Gaurang. All right, so I hope I'll start. So good afternoon, everyone. This is Parvez here. Actually, I graduated from JP University from the batch of 2018. And I graduated from the branch of mechanical engineering. So I hope you guys might know that. But I'll start with I got offered for the position of a technical recruiter with a client, with company known as Collabra. And basically we started working as a technical recruiter since the month of August 2018, right? This call, I think it is just a quick overview that I'll be giving to you guys, like what is staffing and recruitment and how these processes work. And I'll be also sharing you the brief idea about this will be basically all about the staffing and how these things work and brief you about what are the skill sets that might be required for a particular person to to apply for the company or maybe that might help you in clearing out the interview process or maybe help you out in joining a particular company over there, right? So first of all, I would like to go through what is basically a staffing and a recruitment process. I'll just give you a quick overview of the company that I work for. It is known as Collabra, and we are basically headquartered in Basking Ridge, New Jersey. So we are a US-based client, first of all. And we have our offices in India that are basically located in Vadodara, Gujarat, and then we have our office in Bangalore. And we are the one of the largest staffing firm that we are working in India, basically, right? Supporting from India, I'll say. So basically, staffing and recruitment, if we talk about specifically about jobs, the process that we go through, of hiring a people for a certain client or any company. So it is quite different from what we go through in our country, in India, and it is quite different in US. So this process that we follow, people are basically getting jobs through staffing firms, right? So we have a lot of staffing firms over there working in US. So as Collabra is one of them. And I'll just give you a brief idea, first of all, how these things work. So the recruitment process is basically over here. I'll just try to give an example, just so that you can have a good brief idea, how this thing is working. So it is there are certain clients the US clients, right? So there are certain clients who have, certain requirements, the requirements as in positions. So a Java developer or maybe a .NET developer or maybe any MuleSoft developer or any sort of positions that might include from, it depends upon the client basically. Let's say I have a client working with me that is Bank of America, and they require a Java developer. So they will roll out the position, right? And they will roll out the position to the staffing firm. And what is the task of the staffing firm is to find an appropriate candidate or the best candidate for them, for the client, that is Bank of America. And they have to then they go through the whole process. The process goes in, we present the resume of a particular candidate to the client. Let's say if it is a Java developer, first of all, we find the Java developer, we have all these tools and system where we find the resume. Those are basically Monster, Career Builder, Dice, Indeed, LinkedIn. And these are basically used by most of the staffing firms. And then we do have many other, sources where we can find the resumes, right? So as I told you, the Bank of America client is looking for a Java developer, right? So we find the candidate, we source the candidate for the client, we present the resume in front of the manager for that particular position. Like let's say it is a Java developer role. So we present around 2 to 3 resumes. If there is a one position, like there is a quota. I'll say like there is a num it is a 1:3 ratio for a specific position that all the clients basically follow. So like if there is one position, we can present 3 resumes and manager can select any one or two of the best resumes from that. And they like schedule the interview. So we like schedule the interview with the client of like let's say I am the can let's say like Gorang is the candidate. He's a Java developer that I have sourced. I am a recruiter and like the Bank of America is hiring, right? So I have sourced Gorang and he has like gone through the details of the position. Like the client who provides like what they are looking for, what is the project duration that they are looking for, what is the specific pay that they are looking for, right? For that particular pay, like let's say the like basically the pay that follows over here is on hourly basis, right? So like let's say $50 on hourly basis it is, right? So I talked to Gorang, I sourced him on from Indeed. Let's say I talked to Gorang, he said okay, everything is fine. He is like basically pretty much okay with the duration of the project. That is like let's say the project is for 12 months for the Java developer, and he is okay with the pay and everything. Like he is looking for the job. He has been in the job market since last 2 or 3 months, and he have been looking for a Java developer role. And like as I talked to Gorang, like he said, okay, yeah, this is the perfect position, and I've been looking to work with Bank of America. The client is good. Like it is one of the Fortune 500 client that we serve. So like I presented his resume to the manager, and the manager liked his resume. And he scheduled it, like the manager scheduled the interview with Gorang, and like we schedule the interview accordingly, like whatever the time slots the client provide, like the manager provide, and you go through the interview process with the manager. We let like we set Gorang up that yeah, this is the interview timings, these are the position details, these might be the appropriate question what the manager might ask you like basically for this particular position. And like yeah, as Gorang has already worked in the past, he knows everything about that. So like yeah, he will go through the interview process, and if the manager finds Gorang like he's the best candidate, he will go through that, he will hire him. So like over here I'll say like the task is still not complete. Then when a particular candidate is hired for a particular job, then he goes through all these processes. Like it is in the recruitment process, recruitment and staffing. Like he goes through like for different client there is a background checks, a drug test, or maybe education check, employment check and everything. And then like he goes through the those process, and then he gets hired and we get him started. So like basically this is what the basic idea of the recruitment cycle is. Like this is a recruitment cycle that particular staffing firm follows for a different client. So it is not just one client. Like there are more than 300 to 400 clients that we serve. Like basically for us, for Colabra, we almost serve like 800 plus clients, and we have almost a workforce of around like 1200 plus recruiters working in the Vadodara office, and then there are in the Bangalore office too. And basically a lot of people, like basically there are other recruiters working in the US too. So like first of all I'll say like this is a US culture that we follow, right? So till now, like whatever I've explained, anyone has any question on that particular part? Like if you do, you want me to like tell you a little bit more, anything, anyone?
Rubhish.
Right, sir.
I have one query. What are today's industrial requirements?
So for getting hired for this particular company or like
Overall, if you can say something general, what about this company, if you can highlight something.
so like as I told you, like we are a staffing firm. So first of all, like what we look for, like if we want to hire a particular recruiter, right, say like for the company, like for Colabra, then what we are basically looking for is someone like who has done their bachelor's. First of all, they should be good, like good with communication skills, like strong verbal and written skills should be there. And We do look for someone with a little bit of a technical knowledge also, like if they have a technical knowledge in the background of like if a particular has an if someone has a knowledge in the IT industry, that is perfectly well, like because whatever the position or like whatever the client roll out the role, like most of them are the ITs, so like they will get a good understanding by reading a specific position, like what the position is all about. And I'll say like what we basically look for is someone like who is more confident, who can go through these like talking to a particular people over the phone or maybe like talking to them over the video. Like it is something like what I'm saying right now is we need someone like who has good communication skills and good verbal skills, plus like who is being confident to talk with anyone over the phone or maybe over the video calls. So like these are the pretty much very basic requirements, and one should be like to clear out the test and everything. Like they should have a good quantitative like aptitude knowledge where like they can clear out, and then there is a group discussion process and the video conferencing interview one has to go through to get hired for the for our company, that is Collabra. So one should like come with a good presentation skill, come with like good presence of mind, I'll say. And basically like a little bit of understanding, like if they have an understanding of staffing and recruitment process over there, like that will be helpful. So like these are the pretty much basic idea, like I would like to say, like what
Okay.
our company in some.
Okay, thank you. Can I ask a bit personal question?
Sure.
How do you feel about JOT after passing out? Can you throw some
Definitely,
light on
like
it?
I would like, definitely, like I would like to thank everyone over there. I definitely feel honored. Like I was a part of JVT. I got like got basically whatever the time of like the whole 4 years that we studied over there, and like working on the different projects with teachers and everything, and whatever they supported us throughout. And I think like it was our year where we had 100% placement. In 2018, so like it was one of the best thing that happened to us. And like I think all of the people like who sat in different jobs, like they were placed, so that was like a wonderful a memory, I'll say, that we have gone through. And yeah, I would like to thank everyone like who has been there and being supportive to me and to everyone like who has gone through all these processes and the steps to like making sure that everyone is getting hired on a different and like started working with company. And I have seen also like many people who were not hired or maybe not joined any particular company in the next 4 to 5 months, like still like our JVT like people from the I'll say like definitely want to put some name over there, like from mechanical engineering and like from the recruitment team, like they have supported them and like made sure that they get the job. So yeah, like that was a good time that we spent over there.
Okay, thank you. One last one.
Sure.
Would you like to give some message to your juniors in this regard? That is how JOT can help our current students so that they can use the university facilities to achieve their goals. Some message or some sort of suggestion would you like to give them?
So definitely, I would like to say that like JVT has been like already helping everyone, making sure that like they sit in every other like whatever the companies that come for the recruitment process, like to recruit. And they have like supported, like I think like when we were in 4th year, like we like the JVT also provided us the aptitude classes over there and everything, so that one can make sure that they can clear out the first step for a particular company to get hired. So like that is one of the positive things like that JUT has helped out throughout the years. I can say that they might have also like they have also helped out in the past and everything. So like that is one of the things, like they make sure that you go through, you know, like whatever the steps are. And I think like once the fourth year start, or maybe like for the 3rd year people also, like they can start the preparation of aptitude basically, like, because that is the very first step. Like all the companies have this first step, that is the aptitude test, right? And then like for a specific knowledge in the in their industry, if they want something in their industry, then they definitely we do have faculties over there that like that they can go through, and like they definitely will provide the help on that part too, and they can help them in like achieving whatever they are looking for. So yeah, that would be something like I would like to say to the juniors, like if they are in second year or third year, like they can start a little bit of a little step where like you can start with the aptitude and a little bit knowledge gaining about the different industries. So you should have a mindset first of all, like where do you want to go, or like what do you want to achieve specifically, or if you want to pursue anything in future, like any other what I'll say is might want to do M.Tech or PhD, like that depends upon you. But yeah, the JUT has been helpful in all those processes too. So I would like to say to the juniors that yeah, you can like start, like take a first step and start something where like whatever you want to achieve in the area.
Okay, thank you, Pravej. I hope these inspiring words will motivate our students and help them achieve their goals. Be safe and stay healthy.
All right, yeah, definitely I would like to say that, yeah, stay safe. I know this is not good, but yeah, everyone has been so much acquainted with the new normal. So yeah, that is something.
Oh, okay. Sorry for the interruption. You can continue with the presentation.
Okay, definitely. I think pretty much I was a little bit clear about the recruitment life cycle that we follow on a daily basis. So I just wanted to check with everyone, like anyone who has any questions about these things, anything that they want to know. Okay, so from the silence, I can see that like people do not have any questions on that particular part. But yeah, like this is what the basic recruitment and staffing, like basically I know like people might do not have a lot of knowledge on staffing and recruitment because like it is a little bit not too much known over there. Like people do not know how these things work. So like once you get into these industries, like you will get the knowledge of that, and like you can like basically learn about the different things. Like it is not just one thing, like there are different things to learn, starting from basically I'll say like if like let's say if you are in the mechanical field also, right? There is a lot of scope. You can like learn about the IT industries. IT knowledge is also there. You can learn a lot more about healthcare clients. You can learn a lot more about like there are many clients that you work like. Mostly I'll say like we do have one of our client that is Harley-Davidson, right? So like you have a certain I would like to explain one thing, that basically like different areas where you can learn different things over there in the company. So yeah, that is the one thing. And basically like I think I was pretty much clear about the staffing and like how these things work. So if anyone like would like to know a little bit more or anything in that particular area, like they can come up and ask a question. Anything from you guys, like I will definitely like.
Good afternoon, Parvez.
Good afternoon, then, sir.
Okay. So can you speak to your juniors that with regard to that whether your studies in any manner helped you or help others though, for getting a job?
Basically, like you learn a lot of different things in your studies, like throughout the whole 4 years. So yeah, like you can find some of these some of the things, like you might if you start working in a different company or with a different client, you see like some of the things are very useful, some of the things are not, right? So like it is not something like it is like whatever you have learned or anything that in the in throughout your 4 years is not going to help you. It is certainly going to help you in a different way, maybe not if not today, and maybe in next 2 years or next 3 years, and in any area, right? Because you know, like whatever, like what we basically look in a people is like coming with a strong verbal communication and like good communication skill, with like being confident. So I think like For those things, like we also have conducted GDs in our basically like group mock group discussions were there that like were conducted by our college over there, like where you can like come up with the different questions and everything that can help you in preparing for the interviews over there. And like, yeah, first of all, like what you need to do is like be more confident whatever you are saying, and be more presentable, right? So you learn a lot of different things on a daily basis, and like whatever the JUET has given, or maybe like whatever we go through on a daily basis, like that sums up basically, and like help you in a daily basis too. Right, wherever you join, like if you want to join a IT firm, or maybe any mechanical jobs, or any field you want to go, right? Like there are vast varieties of fields over there where you can start working. So yeah, these will be helpful in future. Plus, like I think one of the person is having a question like how to prepare for an HR interview. Mm-hmm. So first of all, like I will say, like the HR interviews are very basic. Like first of all, they will ask you like, tell me about yourself, right? So if you're telling about yourself, like first of all, like if you're going through an interview process, you need to have a particular mindset, like whatever you are going to speak, you're going to say it in a proper way where the interviewer can understand you. It is not like something that you have just written it down and and just, you want to say those things like, tell me about yourself, so I'm pervious, I'm this, and this. It is not something, but you have to be a little bit more presentable for in front of the interviewer. Like he should know that whatever you are speaking, you are confident about that, and you know like what you are speaking, right? So this is the very first step, and the things that you are speaking, it should be more clear in front of the interviewer. Like if a certain HR is interviewing you for a position, like you should be like pretty much more I'll say like the way of communication should be pretty much where if I'm saying a specific thing, like someone should understand that. The first of thing is that, like, be confident and whatever you are saying, and say it loud and clear and slow so that someone can pretty much understand what you are saying. That is the first thing. And yeah, as I already told you, like, for the only thing is that whatever you are saying, you should be confident about that, right? So these are the one or two things that like you can basically come up. And yeah, like there are a lot of the questions over there, so you should know like what the answers can be for those, so you can like basically prepare for those things too. But good communication skills and these things like should be there in your HR interview. Okay, thank you, Arshu. Anything else, guys? Like I would like to basically like, you know, whatever.
So like you shifted from the Mac background to the IT one. So how was the transition? Like what all difficulties you faced, or like what things can you tell about that, something?
So basically like in the starting, you will like, there is a training given, like there is around month of a training provided by our company. So you go through, it is not just only one thing, like one only the in the IT part, like there are a lot of areas that you work on. So like whatever the requirement, like let's say I'm giving just an example, like whatever the requirements that we get, like if it is a particular IT requirement, so like you go through the process, like there are managers and everyone like who help you in understanding the things, like what should we look for. And we do have our learning and development team in Collabra who help you in like learning about all these processes and everything, right? So they will train you, like around 1 month of a training is there, where like training class is there, and then on floor trainings are there. So like they will let you know everything. And basically it is very simple, like once you start working on a certain things, and you know, like you have a basic idea like how these things will work, like they basically give you the idea about that. But yeah, you should be pretty much like grab the things quickly so that like it will be easy for you to start something, like whatever you are working on, right? So that is the first thing. And like it is just not the transition into IT phase, like where I'll say, but if you read the things specifically and like if you try to understand those things, like it becomes easy. And you keep on working on the same things again and again. So you have a good and great idea about that particular thing. Like, let's say any specific knowledge you have regarding any sort of a developer or any software engineer or anything like that. So like that can be helpful. And someone came with a question like, what are the mechanical skill set? Basically, whatever we have learned. So I'll say that like some of the things were useful over there, like whatever we learned throughout the 4-year duration. And I know like the people do face like mechanical people graduating from mechanical engineering do have lots of questions like what the industry that they should join over there. So, or maybe like what are the field that they can go. So I like to say like basically there are vast varieties of fields that you can go into. But yeah, like whatever you learn throughout your mechanical engineering, like you can apply in different fields, first of all, right? There are lots of fields over there that you can work on. So it is not just only about one or two things. Like many people are working in a different background and have been successful, like maybe in the sales development part. And like people have been basically, I think like previous, like lots of sessions were conducted in the past too. Like people started as GEDs and like they are, GTs, and like they are over there as seniors over there too, working in the different different companies. So like lot of the areas are there where you can join, not specifically anything, not one or two. But yeah, like if you come and start exploring about the jobs and everything, so you will find a wide variety, right? It is not just only one specific or two specific thing that people think that, yeah, mechanical engineering is something that we cannot get a job in the market or something like that. It is not like that. Anything else, guys? Like, thank you, Adit.
So any other skills, like you told about communication and the confidence, other than that, any academic skills or something like that is required?
Sorry, I didn't get that. Any?
You talked about communicational skills and all. Any other skill other than if we go about talking about English or something like the communication part, any other skill than that is required from previously other than the...
So for my, like for whatever I'm working with Collabra, right? So like basically they will first of all look in a specific person, like if anyone is interviewing you for hiring as a technical recruiter, like they will first of all look for a communication skill and the way that you present yourself and how confident you are on presenting yourself. Like these are the first three things that they will look, right? And yeah, like you come with a bachelor's degree, so that is something that they are already looking for. But yeah, other than that, like the aptitude and all.
Okay, thank you.
Anything else, guys, like where I can help you out with? Anything, anything that...
So I guess there is no question left.
Okay.
Okay, sir. On behalf of SAE JVT India, I would like to thank you, sir, for your precious time and your marvelous words and views. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Gurang, and thank you everyone for joining. Thank you, Dhananjay sir and Bhagat sir, also for being on the call. I hope you all have a good day and have a good weekend ahead. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.